Hello student, welcome to my channel. This is Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. Today we will solve one problem related to multiplexer. The problem statement is design 32 to 1 multiplexer using 74LS150. So we need to design 32:1 multiplexer using 74LS150. Now 74LS150 is a 16:1 multiplexer. 74LS150 is a 74LS150. This is the IC number. It is a 16:1 multiplexer. So 16:1 multiplexer means what? First of all, let me repeat first. Multiplexer is a device. It is an electronic device which has got many input and one output. That means at any time it will pass one of the input to the output based on the control lines. Based on the control lines, one of the input is moved to the output. That is called as multiplexer. And in case of 16:1 multiplexer, which has got 16 input lines and one output lines, now you have to decide how many control lines are there in 16:1 multiplexer. So in order to decide how many control lines required for 16:1 multiplexer, we have a formula 2^m is equal to 16. That is 2^m is equal to 16. Now what is the value of m? M is nothing but 4. 2^4 is equal to 16. That means 16:1 multiplexer has got 4 control lines, that is A, B, C, D. But now using this 16:1 multiplexer, you have to design 32:1 multiplexer. So first decide how many control lines are required for 32:1 multiplexer. For 32:1 multiplexer, if you apply the same formula, we need 5 control lines. So let me call the 5th control line as E. So E, A, B, C, D. Now when you take 16:1 multiplexer IC here, which has got 4 control lines, and we have to use, according to the problem statement, we have to use a 16:1 multiplexer to design 32:1 multiplexer. So 32:1 means 32 input. To get 32 input, I need to add 2 multiplexers, 16:1 multiplexer. This is the first one, and this is the second one. When you club 2 multiplexer of 16:1, you will get 32:1. But what about control lines? So we know 16:1 has got 4 control lines. Let me short all the 4 control lines, like control line A of the first multiplexer is shorted with the control line A of the second one. B is shorted with the second one. C is shorted with second one. Like that I will get 4 control lines. 5th control line, what I will do is I will use enable signal of the multiplexer. So I will short the enable signal of the multiplexer with inverter. So what is the use of this one? See, when you see 32-bit table or 5-variable truth table, you can see for the starting 16 combination, E value remains 0. Next 16 combination, E value remains 1. So same concept I am using here. When E is 0, then since it is an active low signal, here you can see the bubble is there, active low signal. This 0 will activate this IC, and this IC will work for the starting 16 combinations. For the next 16 combination, when E becomes 1, this IC will get deactivated and this IC will work. That means when E is 0, first IC will work, and depending on the combination of the ABCD, one of the input is moved to the output. When E is 1, depending on the combination of ABCD, one of the input is moved from here, D16 to D31 is moved to the output. At any time, one of the input is moved from the input to the output. And we know, according to the definition of the multiplexer, multiplexer is a device which has got many input and one output. So here you need to add one OR gate to club the input so that you will get only one output. In this way, you can design 32:1 multiplexer by using 16:1 multiplexer. Now we will see the second problem. In the second problem, design 8:1 multiplexer by using 2:1 multiplexer. So 2:1 multiplexer has got one control line. 2:1 multiplexer, let me write here. It is a 2:1 multiplexer. That means it has got two inputs. Let me write here two input D0 and D1 and one output Y. So to decide the control lines, 2^m is equal to 2. That means in order to control two input, I need one control line. In 2:1 multiplexer, we have one control line. By using 2:1 multiplexer, now you have to design 8:1 multiplexer. So now the question comes, how many 2:1 mux is required to form 8:1 mux? So that means it need here 4 2:1 mux. So we need 4 2:1 mux to form 8:1 mux. So in order to design 8:1 multiplexer, we need 4 numbers of 2:1. So we need 4 numbers of 2:1 mux. When you add 4 numbers of 2:1 mux, then that becomes 8:1 mux. But how many control lines are required? In order to control 8 lines, if you put the same formula, 2^m is equal to 8, then the value of m is equal to 3. That means I need 3 control lines. So 3 control lines in the diagram you can see is marked as S0, S1 and S2. These are the 3 control lines. Other than that, you can see the connection here. That is, I have connected 4 2:1 mux. Data input for the first mux is D0, D1. Data input for the second mux is D2, D3. Data input for the third mux is D4, D5, D6 and D7. And output of this first mux and second mux, once again clubbed with the one more mux, 2:1. And similarly, third and fourth one is clubbed with the once again 2:1. Similarly, you have to club with the output of the next stage with the once again 2:1 to get the single output. See, once again we repeat here, mux is nothing but an electronic device which has got many input and one output. So in order to get 8:1 mux, you have to connect 2:1 mux in 3 stages. This is the first stage and this is the second stage and this is the third stage. Now here you will see how 8:1 mux works exactly. I have written the truth table for 8:1 mux. So we have 3 control lines, S0, S1 and S2. And we know the input values also. Here it is written input value D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7. I have written the input value, that is data value 1010. I have written randomly. So now let us take the control line value is 010. Control line value is 010. So let us take the control line value, that is 010 means S2 is 0. S1 is 1, S0 is 0, and the corresponding input value for this combination is 1. That means when the control line is 010, 1 is moved out to the output. So here it works in this way. Here you have to apply the reverse engineering. So when S2 is 0, you have to see first S2 is 0. When S2 is 0, this control line is 0, then this line will work. When this S2 is 0, S2 can take either 0 or 1. When S2 is 0, when the control line S2 is 0, this line will work. Now this IC will work here. In this IC, you have to see S1 is 1. So once again you have to take here which is S1 is equal to 1. S1 is 1 means this IC will work. And here in this IC, when S is 0 means here D2 line will work, and whatever input present on the D2 line, so the input present on the D2 line is 1, that is moved to the output, that means y is equal to 1. Now let us take one more example. I will take control value is equal to 110. I will take control value is equal to 110. First decide what is S2, S1 and S0. S2 is equal to 1. When S2 is equal to 1, this line is get selected and this IC is get selected. Now S1 is 1, once again this line will get selected in this IC and this IC will get selected. And S0 is 0 in this IC, 0 means this line will get selected. That means D6 value will be moved out of the multiplexer. What is the D6 value? D6 value is 1. So you will get Y is equal to 1. In this way 8:1 multiplexer works.